been a hot minute, man. I got mail calls. I got news on Kickstarters. Got a little brief rundown of some stuff that I picked up over at Long Beach Comic Con. It was a couple weeks ago. I've been real, real busy. Haven't had a chance to get onto these videos. So let's just kick right into it. All right. So we got a couple shout outs right now. Brian Polito, man, congratulations on your Lady Death Kickstarter, all-time highs. I am super excited to get that connecting cover that you have come out on that one, plus all the free goodies right there. I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little excited to pick up that that Monty Moore cover that you threw in on that one. Also too, shout out to Ron Zabala, my buddy, over at Mount Olympus Comics, Samurai of Oz 2. Did really good on the Kickstarter. I know he broke some records on that one. Super happy for you on that one, bro. That was good shit. So a lot of you guys know I was over at Long Beach Comic Con a few weeks ago, 2-3 weeks ago, hanging out with Ron over at his booth right there, hanging out with him, another corner member and artist that's actually got a few covers that are going to be coming out, two of them on a couple of these Kickstarters, and he's starting right now, Ruben Rosas. So let's get on to that news right now, okay? So we got one Kickstarter that's going to be kicking off tomorrow. That is from a very, very cool lady that I happen to meet through those guys. That's Wendy. I'm not going to say her last name because I butcher last names, but Wendy, you know who you are. She runs the Naughty Fairies and the Stripper Assassin. That's one of the little more racy books. But for those of you guys that like that naughty stuff, this is right up your alley. I'm going to show you guys a few of the covers she's got going on, man, from Ruben Rosas to the Harrigan. You know, all the names that we love right here on the corner, she's got them doing covers for her too. So get on board. We're going to start posting some links for that stuff right there. Get on board with Wendy. Check it out. I believe we even got she got a cover from Steph too, Steph Wilson. That one's gonna be coming out, and we got another Kickstarter gonna be kicking off in October. That is one I'm really, really hyped for, man. When I met Jacob over at Fiend Fest. That's when I met him. Then we hooked up again back over at WonderCon when I was there with Ron Zabala. And he hooked me up with the issue that him and Chad had did. It was called Yule's Vision. Wasn't aware of it. Instantly hooked, loved the art, quality stock, everything was good. Now we've got the issue 2 that's going to be coming out on the Kickstarter. That's to be in the beginning of October, I believe. I'm going to put it right up here. So that's been kicking out. I'm real, real stoked on this one. I mean, you know, it's not very often that Kickstarters come out that I just jump right on board with, get really, really involved with. But cool guys, love the content they're putting out. So of course you do it here on the corner, man. We support everybody that's out there trying to make it in this industry. So we got Wendy, all right, with the Naughty Fairy Stripper Assassins. That's going to be coming out tomorrow. Stay tuned. I'm going to plug in the shit out of Collector's Corner and our Instagram page too. If you haven't seen those on Instagram, we also have one over there. That's Collector's Corner IG. It's going to be collector_corner_IG. So we'll be doing a lot of stuff over there for promotional use. That's pretty much what we're going to be doing on that one. But without further ado, I'm going to get into some of these mail calls and shit that I got. All right. So first off, you know, I didn't mention on there's two actually that I didn't. I forgot to mention on my last video. Just so much stuff, but from Brian Polito, I got the on the La Muerta. That's probably one of my favorite characters right now. Yo. So I picked up the jeweled edition. I had to get this because I always go for the jeweled editions unless it's something like really crazy, like the connected cover that just came out. Not only that, this is Nathan Sergi. All right, I believe I'm saying the name right. I met this dude over at WonderCon. Fell in love with his art. I mean, I've been picking it up anywhere I see it. Just phenomenal artist. I've got him all over right there. Some more of his work. I also got him on my walls right there. That's his work right there. And I even got some more stuff I'm going to show you later on in the video. But as far as that one right there, I also got this, the Freedom Martha right there. Beautiful Joel Gomez cover right there, man. You can't beat that shit. And you guys have never met Joel. Joel is an awesome dude. Met him over at Fiend Fest. Him and his lady Beth, who also does work over on the, what is it, Dia de los Muertos. She did a lot of those covers for, what's it, Joel, I forgot his name. The guy does Lady Mechanica. I don't know why that's in there, but also picked up because like I didn't want to get the hardcover because I just needed something bigger to display. I needed it to be a little bit more. So I picked up this beautiful print right there from one of our own members, Michael Moore. Can't go wrong with that. Who could ask for more? Alright, so now on to some other stuff that I picked up. Let's see. While I was over at Long Beach Comic Con, you know, I was prowling the aisles, and then I seen another creator right there. He was, he had came over because he was talking to Ron, and I seen his shirt. I liked his shirt. I was like, hey, is that your comic book? He's like, yeah. I'm like, okay, why don't you give me a copy? Let me check it out. And I'm glad I did. This is right here. It is from Pocket Jacks. It is Guinevere, the Divinity Factory, issue 1 of 5. This was really cool, really cool art. It's got that Doctor Strange, Great Gatsby feel. Interiors were great. I loved it. I mean, I'm actually hooked on this one. I know he has another one that came out too. He was also pimping this one over at Long Beach Comic Con. It's based off a true story. That one is called White Lily. It's about some women bomber pilots or fighter pilots, I believe they got. That went down behind the line and all that stuff. But anyways, it's cool. But if you guys get a chance, check this out right here from Pocket Jacks. I'm really digging this. And I believe, yeah, his name was Preston Poulter. But anywho. That's what we're looking at right there. So go ahead, give that one a whirl. Great issue. Can't go wrong with that. Picking me up on a leash from Sleazeway. Can't go wrong with that. What else I got? Okay, my Ron Zabala.
Access 50 million songs.
My Kickstarter for my Samurai of Oz. When you buy select Gillette or got this cover right here. And I also got this one right here. This is awesome. This was a freebie threw in there for me from Tone. So anyway, if you guys haven't got on board with it, you guys need to get over to his Etsy page and Etsy, and pick you up a copy of that. We got the second one. That one just kicked off, so I'm sure he's gonna be having opportunities to jump on board with that one. Now, another thing I picked up from Ron while I was there, of course, on the Nathan Sturdy tip, I picked up both of these beautiful covers, both colors. The amazing iPhone 11 is here. Also got this awesome book right here. This is a con exclusive that was only for Long Beach, done by one and only Ruben Rosas. Right there. This is another one I'm actually looking forward to. Collateral D coming out from Mount Olympus. So I got that. Of course, got all these really cool prints. Oh, I didn't even realize it's a double-sided one. And it's double-sided because it is forbidden. On all the cool stuff that comes with that. Also picked up this beautiful cowboy book, the Buffalo Patriotica. Jesse Witchman Valkyrie. Look at that. That's just fucking stunning, isn't it? So I got that one. And of course, another Nathan Sturdy. So I got those from Ron. So now let's get on to some stuff that I picked up while I was over there at the con. I want some dollar bin die. Oh wait, before I do that though, man, I gotta give a big shout out to Tony Buck. Tony Buck went out of his way to track down a book. Now there was a book that was given when you went to Fiend Fest that was like your gift for, you know, like it came with your ticket and stuff like that. Being that I took my wife, I had two of them. When we found out about a few people that were kind of in some dire need, I put both of those exclusive books up in auction. It's not that I regretted it, it's just that I really liked the books. So Tony went out of his way to track one of the ones that I actually had auctioned off, and he got it back and he sent it back to me. It's out of the kindness of his heart. So Tony Buck, I appreciate that. Back in my hands. I mean, it went to a good cause, and you know, you hooked it up. You are my fucking man. I can't wait to see you again over at the Swarm Fest. All right, so now back on to the stuff that I picked up over at Long Beach Comic Con. I went Dollar Bin dirt bagging, and I picked up a bunch of really cool books. And all these books right here that I got, with the exception of maybe a couple of premiums, I got all of those from, I believe it was Red Hood Comics. Now, I gotta give it up to these guys. Everything was bagged and boarded. All these comics were in great condition. They were all $1. When there were some comics that I got here, other vendors were actually selling these things off for like 10 bucks a pop. You know, but I picked them all up for a buck a piece. So, picking up this cool Predator, too. Mark of Terror, Glow in the Dark Ghost Rider. Another Predator 2. Some Jim Lee goodness. They're part of the Tim Drake story. The breaking of the bat, dude. A buck. And this thing is in pristine condition too, man. I don't see no spine breaks, no rounded corners. I mean, for a buck. Other vendors were selling this for 10 bucks. More than Tim Drake. I like Tim Drake. I think he's a very underrated character. Also picked up this awesome Mighty Mouse number 1 homage cover right there. And then, you know, I picked these up. Really, I just picked them up because they looked really cool and it's a Finch cover, but it got me this awesome Moon Knight Spider-Man. That Moon Knight. That just happened to be in there. Hawk and Dove number 1, Liefeld. What else did I get here? I think that was it for what I picked up. And then I got a couple of these from the guys over there. Aspen Comics was there too, pimping out their stuff. I brought these with me. This is the only thing I actually took in to get signed. I picked these up in a dollar bin, actually 50 cent bins, not too long ago. Went and got them signed by the artist. He was there at Long Beach Comic Con. So I got those signed. Also got this bad boy signed. Now this was the only one I seen. Mike Mayhew was over there, so I actually chopped it up with him for a while. Really cool dude, man. I picked this up from him. It was the only one I've seen that was signed in that beautiful like pinkish color. So I got that. It's the Virgin COA on there. Thanks, Mike. I appreciate that for hooking me up with that. That was really cool. Now, last thing I got over there before I get to my last Kickstarter. Sorry, this video is going a little bit long, but like I said, it's been a while. All right, was I got from Ruben Rosas, I got his line work. Now, I'm going to show you guys this. This is kind of a sneak peek at Willow. Now, I've already talked with Jake Lavalle. He said it was cool to go ahead and show this. So, we're going to get a sneak peek at Willow from Yule's Vision. That's going to be coming out in the Kickstarter next month. So, get on board with that. There we go, ladies and gentlemen. Look at how beautiful this is. Artist Ruben Rosas. This is right here. This is his book he was giving out to people, just, you know, showing off all of his work that he's got in there. This is the one I believe he's working on right now. The cover that I showed earlier. I'll show it again. For Wendy. We got some Patriotica. No, I believe. Is that Patriotica? I forgot which one that is. I know it's from Mount Olympus, but. That was for the WonderCon. We did. I have that cover as well. Boom! Look at those. Fucking beautiful, right? Oh man, I'm so stoked for this book coming out, guys. I can't even tell you. This one too. This is the one he did for Wendy. I'm excited about this one too. I'm gonna have to go ahead and pick this up once that Kickstarter goes live tomorrow. Also got this. I really like this one too, man, because this was some team. I love team books, and that actually came together really, really good, man. There's another one. This is a. That is Ruben Rosas right there. Now, last but not least, man, this is one that I can't believe I forgot to fucking talk about, forgot to mention, but our own Todd, the motherfucking War Dog. I got that Kickstarter, got the, you know, the challenged chip too. I carry that with me all the time. I had to go with all the covers. Now my blank one, I actually gave that to Ron Zabala because he got a custom job done on it for Todd. I wouldn't spoil that. But picked up this cover. I love that one. That's so cool. Everybody's favorite. And my personal favorite, man. Right there. Me and my boy guys right there on the cover. I appreciate you guys, man, for doing this. It was really cool. You included me on the book. I got my little cameo in the back too. Sorry, spoiler, but if you haven't picked it up yet, man, I don't know what to tell you. If you need a digital copy, get at me and I'll see if Todd lets me send you a digital copy of it, alright? But the crew, awesome. I can't wait for issue 2 of that. And more and more and more. It's gonna be fucking awesome. So that is it for my mail call, guys. I know that was kind of a long-winded video. Don't forget, we have tomorrow, we have Naughty Fairy Stripper Assassins kicking off, right? You're going to have to get on that one. And then in a couple next month, we also have Yule's Vision. Yes, finally, issue number 2, man. That's going to be fucking coming out pretty soon. Can't wait for that shit. And that's pretty much it, man. I know I haven't been around for a while. I've been real, real busy. But I'm still in the game, all right? So I'll talk to you guys later. Shazam, bitches.